Greetings everyone, in this video I will show you how to run stable diffusion xlarge on RunPod, as you are seeing here, and I will do some comparison with Midjourney generated images. I will also show you the difference between non-refiner and what happens when we use refiner steps. Moreover, I will explain how to generate as many as images you want, and also how to generate bigger batch size images, like generating 8 images at the same time, how to use refiner strength, how to use steps, and how to use CFG scale. So for this tutorial, I prepared a very detailed GitHub Readme file. All of the instructions and commands are written here. I will update this file as it be necessary. Moreover, the link of this file will be in the description of the video and also in the comment section of the video. So I have both auto installer script and also manual installation steps. Let's log in into our RunPod account. Click this link. If you don't have an account, just sign up. If you have account, log in. Go to Community Cloud. From here, select your internet speed very high. This is important because we are going to download a lot of files. You can use any GPU which has over 20 GB. For demonstration, I will pick one RTX 3090. Very important thing is customize deployment and increase volume disk size to 200 GB. Also from templates, type stable and select RunPod Fast Stable Diffusion and hit continue. Hit deploy. Let's call this machine as manual installation. Let's also start another machine. For this machine, I will use RTX A6000. This is 59 cents. The other one was 29 cents. But this machine has 48 GB VRAM. So let's also customize deployment. Select volume disk 200 GB. Also, our template is selected. Continue and deploy. Let's name this machine as Auto Install SDXLarge. Auto Installer script is very easy to use. Go to this link. From here, download this attached SH file. Click it. It will download the SH file. Once the RunPods are started, you will see connect button enabled here. Patiently wait them to download the necessary files. Both of the pods are now ready. Let's begin with automatic installation connect. Connect to JupyterLab. Wait until JupyterLab interface loads. Click this upload files icon. Select the downloaded file. You see the downloaded file is uploaded here. Start a new terminal. Copy the link here. Copy it. Paste the command here. It will automatically install everything for you. You don't need to do anything else. Let's continue with manual installation because we will execute a lot of commands. Connect to JupyterLab. So the manual installation is explained here. You need to have Hugging Face account. If you don't have a Hugging Face account, just click join, register from here. Once you have your account, click login from here. Now you need to accept terms and conditions of these two repositories. I will show you, click and open them. So here the first repository, how you are going to accept, you see they have researcher early access agreement. Go to the very bottom and in here fill as you wish. I will fill as an example NA and I accept the above license agreement, submit application. Then we need to generate our Hugging Face access token. So open this link. Here, generate a new token, test, I will make as a read, generate token, copy it. After you copy it, paste it into a text file like this. Now we can begin executing the commands below. So open a new terminal, copy the first one, paste and hit enter, copy the next one, paste and hit enter, then copy the next one, paste and hit enter. Of course, you are waiting the commands here to be completed. Copy this one, paste that, hit enter, copy this one, paste it, enter, copy this one, paste it, enter. Okay, then let's continue. This is a repository that I have edited to provide you the Gradio interface that is very easy to use, very convenient to use, and supporting Refiner of SDX large. For automatic installation, you don't need to do anything. It will install everything. Manual installation is installing the requirements right now. Once you see like this, it means that the previous execution has been completed and you can continue. Copy, paste, hit enter. Copy, paste, hit enter. Copy, paste, hit enter. Okay, this step is very important. This will clone the SDXlarge version 0.9 into our workspace. However, for this to be working, we need to edit this URL. So copy it in the notepad file, paste it. So copy your Hugging Face token and replace this part. Also here, you need to write your Hugging Face username. So my username is here. I will copy it from here and I will paste it here. Then copy the command and execute it in this screen. So you will see that it will start downloading all of the SDXlarge files into this folder. You need to wait here patiently because it will download about 100 GB of files. That is why selecting high speed port is very important. These files will permanently remain on your workspace as long as you keep your RunPod, as long as you don't delete your RunPod. First, repository cloning has been completed. You will get a message like this. Then we will continue, copy this. This will delete all of the .save tensors files because we will use .binary files with our Gradio interface. And since this is running on cloud, you don't have anything to worry. Copy paste and hit enter. Why I am doing this? Because I am opening extra space in our pod. So then copy this command, hit enter. Then copy this, hit enter. And we also need to modify this link. Copy from here. We need to copy the username and we need to copy the access token. Then copy the command like this and copy paste and hit enter and wait this one to be cloned as well. This repository is smaller than the previous one, so it won't take as long as this one. Both of the installations have been completed, both manual and also automatic. Of course, automatic was fully automatic. Then for running it after installation, all you need to do is running this command. Also, I have put the run command here. They are basically same. So let's start our SDXlarge Gradio application. Moreover, if you don't want to use Refiner, just set this enable Refiner to false. Okay, let's copy paste it in both of the run pods. You see it is loading the pipeline as you are seeing right now in both of the run pods. I am going to open is the manual one. So this is our interface. Enter your positive prompt here, enter your negative prompt here, set the number of images that you want to generate from here. Let's begin with this prompt. I will compare it with latest version of Midjourney. Copy text, paste prompt here. Let's delete the unnecessary part like this. I'm not going to use any negative prompt, just hit generate. And this is the automatic RunPod. So the difference is that automatic RunPod has a better GPU, manual RunPod has a weaker GPU. During the image generation, it is going to use all of your GPU. The GPU memory used is like this. Okay, we got the results. So this is our result. The left one is the one without Refiner. The right one is the one with Refiner. So let's open in a new tab like this. The native resolution is 1024 by 1024. This is without Refiner and this is with Refiner. Also, this is another image generated in the other pod. So this is without Refiner and this is with Refiner. I think there is a significant improvement with Refiner. Now I will delete the manual installation pod to not waste my money. And I will continue with automatic installation to show you more examples. And this was the Midjourney art. So it is up to your taste. Let's try this prompt. Copy it, paste into prompt. Okay, looking good. I am not using any negative prompts and this is affecting my results. Maybe let's add some low quality. On the Jupyter lab, you can see the progress. It is 5 IT per second right now with batch size 1. Okay, and here we got our result. So let's open new tab and let's also open this new tab. Okay, this is 512 resolution and this is 1024. Let's add some more negatives. Okay, I have written some simple negative prompts. In the advanced setting, you will have batch size. So people were asking me what is number of images and what is images here. This is batch size. If I make this 4, it will generate 4 images at the same time. If I set this 4, it will generate 4 times images with the batch size here. So it would be 16 images. As a beginning, let's try with batch size 4. Refiner strength and steps are default. And this is the CFG scale. You can also change it. You can also change the refiner strength and the number of steps that you want to use for generating images. Let's hit generate and let's see how our pod performs when generating 4 images at the same time. This is the GPU memory used as you are seeing right now. Now our IT per second is 1.33, but we need to multiply it with 4. So it is basically 6.2 IT per second. This is without refiner. Now the refiner step is coming up. Okay, with refiner it was 1.22 IT per second. We got the results. Let's check it out. Okay, here are results. On the right, we see the images generated with refiner, on the left without refiner. I think the results are pretty good. Let's see, let's open. So this is the result we got. Refiner is making huge improvement as you are seeing. Okay, let's try this prompt. Copy text, open a notepad file, delete the unnecessary part like this, copy it, paste into here, and let's set number of images to 10, and I will set the batch size back to 1, and let's also increase number of steps to 100. Okay, let's hit generate. This time it will generate 10 images, but one by one. You can see the progress here. While generating images, let me show you where the generated images are saved. Enter inside Stable Diffusion XLarge demo folder. In here, enter inside Stable Diffusion XLarge demo. In here, you will see outputs and all of the generated images will be saved here. The saved images are the images after refiner steps. So with double clicking, you can open them. You can also download entire folder as an archive, but using RunPod CTL would be much better for you. In this tutorial, I have shown how to use RunPod CTL. Open it. This is a pretty long tutorial. Look for the chapters where you want to learn. Just look at the description of the tutorial. You will see the chapters here and just click the chapter that you want to go. During the image generation, the images will not be displayed here. However, if you want to see them, go to the outputs folder and in the very bottom, you will see the last generated images. You can double click them, open them, or you can right click and download them if you wish, like this, click download. I already have 2 tutorials for SDXL for Google Colab and for local installation and usage as well. I also added the links of these 2 tutorials to the Readme file as well, like this. Okay, the images were generated. I think the quality is amazing. Let's look at them in the new tab. Okay, I am opening them like this. Right click, open new image. And I will compare with the Midjourney as well. Let's decide which one is the best one. Okay, they are all looking pretty amazing if you ask me. Okay, let's close. This is also a good one. Let's close. This is also a nice one. Okay, so this image is generated by Midjourney, which you pay a decent amount of money every month. You are seeing here the Midjourney image, and these are SDXL version 0.9, not even the officially version 1. And the quality is amazing. Let's compare these 2 like this. Let's decide which one is looking best. Okay, I can't decide which one is the best. Maybe let's compare this post. So copy image, open paint.net. Let's make the double size like this. On the left, we see the stable diffusion X large image. So on the left, we have stable diffusion X large, which is free to use. On the right, we have Midjourney latest version. Let's say you want to turn off non-refiner images. What you need to do is go to your stable diffusion X large demo folder. In here, you will see up7.py. Open it. In this file, you will find this section. Okay, in here, all you need to do is comment out here. Once you did comment out this line of code, it won't display images anymore. Control S and save, or you can save it from here, save Python file. After saving the file, restart your pod, which will be easiest way for you. Restart pod. Once pod has been restarted, click JupyterLab again. You will get this until pod has been restarted. Copy the run command from here again. Open a new terminal. Copy paste and hit enter. The initial loading doesn't take too much time, so it is not a problem to restart pod. This time let's try this prompt, copy text. I will copy the prompt here. The restart has been completed. Click the Gradio app. Copy paste the prompt. Let's also copy our previous negative prompts. Let's generate 4 images. Generate. You can watch the progress from here as you are seeing right now. It is doing 5 IT per second when batch size is 1. So what about refiner strength? What is it doing? When you set steps 50 and refiner step 30%, it will do 15 refiner steps and 50 original steps. So if you make this 100, it will do 100 steps to generate initial image, then 30 steps to generate the refined image. This is what does refiner steps do. So this is why 50 steps are used for initial generation and 15 steps are used for refined image generation. Okay, the images have been generated. This is SDXL large. You see non-refiner images are not shown anymore. Let's compare with the Midjourney. So this was Midjourney image. This is Midjourney. And this is stable diffusion X large. Let's open a new tab. Okay, stable diffusion X large. And here we got the Midjourney. This is all for today. I hope you have enjoyed. Please support me on Patreon. This is tremendously important for me. You will find the link here. Also, you can join our YouTube channel and support me. Please like, subscribe, leave a comment. I am replying all of the comments. You can also click here and start my GitHub repository, fork it and watch it. It will also help me. Hopefully see you in another amazing tutorial.